Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, live from the Christmas room. I've got another Christmas present idea for you.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
All right, this one is not photography related, but it does have something to do with light. Now, every night when I take out our little pumpkin pie here, where is he? I guess today we're not going to have a jingle bell time because he's going to be in the video today. All right, sit down. Over here. Sit down. That's it. Every night I take him out to do his duty, his you-know-whats, you-know-wheres outside. Right, jingle bells? And we go outside and we go potty. Right? Is that what we do at night? And it's dark outside. Well, you know, you got flashlights. I got one. It's built into my phone and so on and so forth. Oh, just make yourself comfortable, dude. How about if you lay down? If you lay down so that people can see you and stop messing up my Christmas stuff. Yes, stop messing up my Christmas stuff. So anyway, I found these two flashlights and I bought one and I'm going like, wow, you ever been impressed with a flashlight? Me neither. Until I bought this one. I'm definitely not going to aim it at the lens, but this sucker, I mean, I can light up the tree across the street in the neighbor's yard at night and see if there's a bird in the tree. That's how bright it is. And it slides up and down. See? Not much, but it focuses and defocuses. And this is a little one. This one takes 4 AA batteries. You know, you would have thought, you'd have thunk that this would take 2 D batteries, right? But no, it takes 4 just regular AA batteries. It is so bright, and it's metal, not plastic, so, but it's got a gasket here. If I unscrew this, you're interested, huh? It's got a gasket, so it keeps the water from going in. Now, I haven't dropped it in the pool or anything, but it's a professional-level flashlight. So this is, the model is HP14. Now, what I like about this one is the power output. It is really, really bright. Again, I'm not going to aim it at the camera lens. If you push it one time, it's super bright. If you let go and you push it again, it's at a much lower level. Then if you let go and you push it again, it's at the bright level again. So I like that. I like that. I like that you could focus it into a wide beam or a very narrow beam. What I don't like is if you're holding the flashlight, this thing can be a weapon to protect yourself. However, if you're holding it like this, and what I mean when I say this can be a weapon to protect yourself, I mean that it's solid. It'll knock someone out. This thing is just like metal, like it's carved out of a solid piece of aluminum. But the button is not here where your thumb goes. You got to hold it like this. You know, the button is back here. See, I'll click. It's got to click on, click off. All right, so now who walks around with a flashlight like this? Somebody can come up from behind you, slide it right out of your hands. I want the flashlight here, okay? And I want the button here. However, for the size, I keep this by the back door. Now, because I like this one so much, this is the HP14. And you don't have to write it down. I'll put a link underneath in the description area. The HP14 is the smaller one. I went and bought the bigger one. Now I feel like, hey, I am the police. And if you think that one's bright, this one is super bright. Now this takes D batteries. I think it takes 3 or 4 D batteries. And if you think you can light up the tree with this one from across the street, this one will probably make the tree catch on fire. That's how bright this is. However, the button is in the right place, right here. So when I go out at night and I turn it on, it's right here. And it has an additional feature. If you turn it on the first time, it's super bright. If you turn it on the second time, it's lower. If you turn it on the third time, it flashes. And it's designed to startle and this is at night now, okay? It's so bright, the strobing light disorients a person if you feel threatened. So it actually is a security piece. And honest to God, if you clobber somebody with this one, they are out. So this is good for a car. This is good for a car. You see the difference in size? I can kind of get them together. It's quite a bit bigger. Is it that much brighter? it's really brighter. Now, the numbers, I don't know. This also has a sliding focus head, just like this one has a sliding focus head. So I didn't think I would be telling you about flashlights, but as I'm looking at what I like to get, I showed you my foaming soap dispenser that I absolutely love. I showed you, I was going to give a secret of what I was going to show you tomorrow. So the flashlights, I keep this one in my bedroom by my bed. If the lights go out, I can light up anybody, anywhere. These are not toys, so I would not take these flashlights, allow the kids to point them at somebody else's eyes. It's that bright. Actually, there's a warning on them about flashing it in the eyes. It's got a beautiful piece of glass. And yes, this one has a gasket on it also, so it's sealed. Excellent. If somebody gave me this for Christmas, I'd open the box. I would be curious what's in this box. And it comes in a beautiful box. I'm sorry I threw the box away. It's like a presentation box. Not only for the bigger one, this one is the HP 17. This one is the HP 14. I'll put the links down below. Click on it. You can see the features. You can read the lumens and all that kind of stuff. I bought both. And I'd buy both again. Honest to God, it's just like, it's a masterpiece flashlight. It's made by Coastal. C-O-A-S-T. There's no A-L. It's made by Coast. So I was wrong. It's made by Coast. So it's a Coast flashlight. I'll put the thing down below so you can click on it. This one is strictly, I think, at Amazon. And yes, I bought them both from Amazon. Now, for the next thing that I have for a Christmas gift idea, I have a Jingle Bells. And how much is the Jingle Bells going to be? I think we would have a price tag of at least $3 billion. And even at $3 billion, I think I would turn it down. Really, I think I would turn it down. Would you sell your little puppy dog for $3 billion? Heck yeah. Well, go away. That's not me. I want this guy. He sleeps with me in bed at night. We're not going to have a Jingle Bell time after. He's actually part of this video because I wanted you to know when I take him out to go potty, I take either this flashlight, which is kept by the door, or I grab this one, which is kept by my bed. Now, the interesting thing is, when I grab this flashlight by my bed, he knows we're going out. All right, talk about dogs understanding stuff. So that's it. That's my Christmas gift idea. Every single gift that I have suggested is a gift that I would like to get, or I would like to give, or both. So these are not just like, oh, what can I tell as a gift idea? Let's go looking online. No, I'm looking around the house at stuff that I would say, this is what I want somebody to buy me, okay? Now, if you want to get me something, I want an Amazon gift card. All right, we're done, Jingles. Thanks, guys, for watching. This is Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, live from the Christmas Room. Please subscribe. Thanks for watching me and Jingles. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.
That's it, baby. That's it. We're done. Yes. You want to go down? You want to go down? You want to get... Yeah. Peter, you tricked me. You want to go down? You want to go down? Oh, we didn't go down again. Peter, you tricked me. You tricked me. What's going on? You want to go down? He knows when I say, do you want to go down? But he's going to go down. All right, we're going this time. Bye-bye.